We have collection spots at all of our fire stations for toys, and we have to have like multiple pickups through the holiday season because we get so many toys donated. It's just so awesome. And for a lot of these families and a lot of these kids, these are the only toys they get for Christmas.
And that's why this is so important.
It means so much. You know, the Unity Shop, it's not only Christmas, it's year round. It helps needy families and, you know, in hard times, but Christmas is like the most special for us.
Well, Christmas is so special, and we really appreciate having you here with us today to talk about the amazing things that we're doing right here in Santa Barbara County.
Thanks for sharing it, Mary.
Thanks. Let's let you unload some more as well.
Keep it going.
This is a wonderful building. When you first walk in on Chapala Street, you will come to a window where clients check in there and the volunteers check in. As you turn around, there's an entry into the waiting room, which is sponsored by the Chumash Indians.
I understand the Unity Shop stands for is to give people their pride back and give people the feeling of family going shopping. And so to create an environment where they can pick and choose himself, and the children know that mom is going shopping with them.
If they decide they need clothes for the children, they follow a little pathway that leads them into the children's clothing area. We also have school supplies there and books so that a mother can help her children with things that the child needs help with.
When people are referred to our JobSmart program, the first step is helping them polish up a resume. It may be an existing one that needs upgrading, or they may need to create one. We'll help them do that. Then we invite them in, and they select the clothing they need for a successful job interview. Once they get that job, we invite them to come back, select a few more outfits, so that they have the right attire for that new career. Last year, we did that for over 400 clients.
Then the most incredible little area that is Santa's toy shop. You will be amazed at all the handmade items there done by seniors. Over 200 seniors in our community are knitting and sewing and making these things. Each child can have two gifts of their choice. They can also have a book and a game and an article of clothing. We have an area that is for the disaster services, and that area has been dedicated to Oprah. Oprah was so kind during the last fire and gave so much to help us help those families. We're very grateful to Kenny Loggins. I think that probably the person that really stayed with us the longest and who really was instrumental in making us successful was Kenny. And one of the ways we thought we could honor him was to open it up to other nonprofit agencies. We will give them all the equipment that they need to do that. And we will set it up for them and even give them staff to operate it so that 100% of the money they raise can go into their coffers. So the move here is completed, and we welcome everybody. We want you to see it. We're very proud of it, and we're happy that we were able to save every one of our services.
I'm here with Allison Spann, the current chair of the Unity Shop Board of Directors. Welcome, Allison.
Thank you, Kenny.
Would you tell us what drew you to Unity?
Yes, Unity has been a partner with the Santa Barbara Association of Realtors for a very long time, since 1917, when Pearl Chase's brother, who was a realtor, got us involved. Mm-hmm. And we're currently, our Unity committee at the association is running a food drive. There are many empty shelves behind me, and we really need the community support. So what I wanted to offer today was that all of our real estate offices have collection bins, and we would certainly like to fill those to help the customers that come to Unity have a warm and happy holiday season.
Well, the food is obviously a necessity for Unity, and especially during the holiday season. Unity started as we originally called it Christmas Unity.
That's
and
right.
It started as a holiday thing for toys and clothes and food, and then gradually became an everyday thing and disaster relief. And so the food that you raise is essential, probably the backbone of Unity, especially during the holidays.
Absolutely. We know that it really helps to feed 100, they have 100 to 200 people a day coming in to Unity for help. And we certainly hope that everyone in the community will support Unity throughout the year and help everyone along their way.
Well, we appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you.
We are so happy to have you with us today.
Well, I'm happy to be here, Barbara. It's a thrill for me to be here every year. I really enjoy it.
We go back a long time.
We do. Yes. We do.
And you've helped so many people throughout the years.
I've done what I could and been coming to this thing for a long, long time. You know, I moved here in 1960, and I've seen a lot of changes over the years, but what you've done has been pretty remarkable.
Well, it's not me. It's a whole community.
It's a community thing. It really is.
It's the old and the young and the rich and the poor and people from all races, creeds, and colors. And
absolutely,
we're all a part. Everybody's helped to build this place. And
I think
you
right.
helped a lot.
Well, I've tried to do what I could and try to encourage other people
to
do things, which is really important.
Well, thank you, Mr. Tobes. And thank everybody for me at the Tobes Group, because we love them all and we appreciate all your support.
Thank you. And, of course, Ann is a big supporter.
Ann.
My darling wife. Keep it going for the next 100 years after this. Maybe not you and I, but other people will take it over.
Stick around.
Well, let's see what we can. Let's see what we can do. We'll work on that.
Hey, hi there. I'm Arthur von Wiesenberger.
And I'm Peter Noon, and we're here at Christmas Unity, and I'm loving every second of it, except the second I was with you.
It's Christmas once again in Santa Barbara.
You know what's good, Arthur? All these kids that you see wandering around here, learning how to do something, you know, instead of going out, like hanging around street corners and getting in trouble like you and I do, they're in here helping to learn how to do things, and that's really nice. You know, I think I'm going to come over next week and I'm going to learn how to do something like that, because all I can do is bloody sing. What can you do?
I can't even sing.
That microphone, that's all you can do. You could come here and learn how to do something and help other people who need help. People in this incredible, we live in this beautiful place, and there are people who are just sort of missing by a little bit, and you can help them. Look at this number. Look at this face. No, don't look at the face. Look at the number.
I'm here with Magda Arroyo, who's a longtime friend of Unity Shop. Magda, you've had a long history with Unity. Tell us a little bit about how far back that goes.
Well, Unity has been a part of me for a really long time. I took advantage of some of the service when I was younger, and it really did help. Now that I'm in the position I'm in, I realize how important the services are and how it really gives you that jump start. Makes you feel like you can move forward and that people care. Mm.
What do you like about Unity? Eddie, you've just been brand new to walking through and seeing this facility for the first time. What do you think?
Well, yeah, I've driven by it so many times, and just getting the history and background of it, it's amazing. It's pretty spectacular, and just the stuff that you guys do, it's just out of this world. And I think it's kind of a precedent what you guys are doing, and kind of saying like a footmark of where everything else should go, and kind of you guys being pioneers.
Tell us why the bank is being supportive of the Unity Shop.
Well, like I said, you know, I've been a part of Unity for a long time. I was on the board. I've seen what they've done for a long time, the non-duplication of services, where they really work with other agencies and they really make an effort to provide everything that they need, and giving them the opportunity to do it themselves, to go shopping, to show their children that they're the ones that are doing it. They're the heroes.
They're providing.
I'm Maria, and I'm a volunteer from Connecticut, and now that I've seen it, I believe in Unity.
We believe in Unity!
We believe in Christmas, y'all.
I'm Matt from Delaware, and I like the way Unity Shop respects people's dignity.
The Santa Barbara Association of Realtors believes in Unity.
We are Bank of California, and we believe in Unity.
I'm Michael Tobes, and I believe in Unity.
1, 2, 3, 4. We believe in Unity.
Welcome to the bakery section of the Unity Shop, and I've got the brain power, the heart behind the shop here, Barbara Tellefson. You've got a special guest.
Yes, I do. I want to introduce you to Nicole. She's a very special lady, and she's going to tell you what she did.
Hi, Nicole.
Did
I had a bake sale at Santa Barbara Design Center, and we raised $1,150 for the Unity Shop.
Congratulations. That's incredible.
And where did you do this? At the Design Center, right?
Yes.
And see, she's learning to take over the business.
She's going to follow in your footsteps. I think she's already ready to fill your shoes. You should be so proud.
I am.
What all did you bake?
We baked some tarts, some cupcakes, cookies, and banana bread.
And you had help?
Yes, I had my friends and my mom.
Oh my gosh, amazing. How many pieces, can I ask, did you bake?
Maybe 400 to 500.
Oh my God, did you see this? Were you down there for the sale?
No, but I knew about it. I'll tell you, this is amazing. And those empty shelves. Products, right?
Looking behind over Nicole's shoulder, you can see a big shelf that is empty. So you feel like getting back in the kitchen and doing any more baking?
Yeah, definitely.
How long did it take you to make all of that?
Maybe 5 to 10 hours.
Wow, that's really, really impressive. Thank you so much for your effort. Boy, she's going to be business, isn't she? Running big time throughout the city here.
There are hundreds of children out there doing their part to make this place work. And we have to say she's a good representative.
Absolutely. Thank you, Nicole. Nice to meet you. Do your part too, won't you, Nipper?
20 years ago, San Marcos School started the Penny Drive. This was a way that all the students could help contribute to Unity. Now it's expanded. They invited other schools to participate. And we've got some of those kids right here. Let's find out who we got. What's your name and where do you school you go to?
I'm Haley and I go to Monta Vista.
I'm Maya and I go to Vieja Valley.
I'm Eloise and I go to Vieja Valley.
I'm Alex and I go to La Colina.
What a great lineup. And back here, Kai's going to tell us, what other schools are involved with this Penny Drive?
Outside of San Marcos, we have La Colina, Vieja Valley, Monta Vista, Adams, Monroe, and Roosevelt School involved.
Wow. And Julia can tell us a little bit about how they actually raise all these pennies.
So the Penny Drive is a service project that we love to do every year in the leadership class at our school. And so how we do it is we take cans and we take them to the elementary schools and then we have them bring in their money and then we collect it, we count it, we convert it at our school, and then we donate it all to the Unity Shop and we get the totals and we let you guys know how much we've raised.
Well, how much does a pound of pennies weigh?
$1.60?
$1.60, there you go. Okay, now one other question. You told me that if you got $40, then you get a little extra time off in the recess, right?
Yes.
That's pretty cool. And how much money did you guys raise so far?
We think around close to $7,500, but we're probably going to exceed that.
Fantastic. Okay, let's go over to Tom and see what he's doing.
I'm here with Craig Thatcher and Boom Chucky. You guys have been performing all over town, helping some kids that don't have what a lot of kids have. How's it going with you?
It's going great. Thank you for having us here.
Yeah, we're loving this. Boom Chuck, everybody.
Yo, Boom Chuck is in the house. Please, please. We're rocking this place with the 1, 2, 3, keep the
Okay, joining us now is Magna Arroyo and your beautiful daughters, and Ronald, of course, but introduce your daughters to us.
This is Brianna Kelly Case, and this is Tatiana Jimenez, and Tatiana's my mentee.
Okay.
So,
yeah. All right, so thank you for all for being here today. Tell us, this. You have a long history with Unity. Tell us about how important this is to you. Bank of California as well, right?
Bank of California. Right. Well, I've been involved with Unity for a long time. I was on the board. As well. And for us, it's just really important to get back to the community. And we're really close to Unity, so we're really excited about this.
Now, why is this so important to you?
Because they give back to the community, and the non-duplication of services is what we really need and will continue to need.
And you've seen it work over the years.
It really works. And the dignity that people have when they actually walk through the store, and it's almost cooler than a different store because you've just got so much here that they're entertained with. So they feel lucky.
Walking through, this is probably neat, isn't it?
Yeah, it's pretty great. I love it here.
Seeing all the toys and how they've set it up for the kids.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I've came here since I was a kid, so it's definitely nice to be back in this place.
Well, thank you very much for joining us. All right, I'm going to step in front of Ronald here. I hope he doesn't mind. We have David Peterson from McDonald's. Thank you for joining us.
You're welcome. Thank you.
So, talking about history here, tell us, your parents go way, way back with Unity.
Oh, gosh, probably 35 years when Constable Christopher Shear was on Haley Street. And my mom was here every day, giving out peanut butter, and my dad as well. And we just absolutely love the Unity shop. And Barbara Tellefson is one of the most amazing females I've ever met on the planet. Just what a dynamo.
What an amazing setup they have here.
Oh, gosh. It's just incredible. It's just so fun. It's so whimsical. You know, you come, and the Ronald's here, so that's always a good thing. Yes, I just love it. It's just a wonderful, wonderful. I think it's, one of the most unique organizations in maybe the world in terms of this type of giving. It's fabulous.
Well, thank you to you and your family for all the years of support to Unity. We really appreciate it.
Love doing it. Love doing it. Merry Christmas.
All right. Merry Christmas. Pick up your phone and call us. The number's on your screen.
The work Unity does in serving over 70,000 people annually. Hardworking families referred by 300 local agencies. That work wouldn't be possible without the partnerships Unity has formed with companies and organizations throughout the community.
Years ago, the Unity shop helped the San Ynez Band of Chumash Indians. And this was long before they had their resort and their casino. And so now it's a heartwarming story and really a human interest full circle story where the Chumash have come back around and are now helping the low-income individuals in Santa Barbara County by sponsoring this section, our client entryway and our food court. And we are so appreciative of the Chumash Indians.
The Unity Shop has been a great partner with American Red Cross because when a family suffers something like the loss of their home, they need immediate help with food, clothing, school supplies, personal items. Unity Shop is really there for the long term. If it takes a year for a family to recover all their household items and to rebuild their home, that's what Unity Shop will provide for them.
The things that the Unity Shop does with providing for people in need in this community, and the Job Smart program, helping people find jobs and equipping them with the right clothing and outfits. It's just a great fit for Bank of America.
The Santa Barbara Association of Realtors has had a long history with the Unity Shop. We've been working with them for 25 years, and we've also had a silent auction at the holiday time for the past 20 years.
This year, with the economy that we're faced with, there are a lot of families that need help getting their kids ready for school.
It's great to be here in the back to school section looking at the clothes and the school supplies, books, etc., and to really see how we can work together to serve our youth and our families and our students.
So when Unity Shop makes these things available, appropriate clothing, the right school supplies, to prepare our students to go to school, it helps the whole community, and that's why Montecito Bank and Trust is proud to support the Unity Shop.
The process of dignity, allowing people to come and shop and support their own families, that's what this is supposed to be all about. It's not just about giving, it's about educating also. And that's the extra step that Unity Shop takes. They educate this community, they educate the individuals that they serve, so it's a beautiful model.
That was very cool.
Thank you.
the years, we've had hundreds of Deckers employees who have come to volunteer at Unity. Our employees love seeing how Unity Shop clients are treated with dignity and respect as they go through the store.
You know, one of the great things about Unity is it is a local charity helping local people, helping families and seniors who need help year-round, not just at Christmas, but all the year round. We believe in local.
I'm Julie McGovern with the American Red Cross, and I believe in Unity.
I'm David Pritchard, Private Client Advisor with U.S. Trust Private Wealth Management and the Market President for Bank of America, and I believe in Unity.
My name is Janica Rufus. I'm the President and CEO of Montecito Bank and Trust, and I believe in Unity.
I'm Ariana from Deckers, and I believe in Unity.
I'm Les Carroll, and I believe in Unity.
Hi there, I'm Arthur von Wiesenberger, also known as Nipper, co-publisher of the Santa Barbara News Press, and I believe in Unity.
I'm George Lease. I'm the regional president for the Central Coast of Union Bank, and I believe in the Unity Shop.
Well, I'm here with Patricia Bragg from Bragg Apple Cider Vinegar, and a brand that is actually international. Patricia, thank you for being with us today.
Oh, Tom, it's wonderful. I love helping at Unity. I'm so proud to be part of it, to help. And I want you to know that my father, Paul Bragg, was the originator of health food stores in 1912.
And you have expanded this brand into many, many products in all over the country. Patricia, you've helped so many, and you're helping a lot of people with nutrition, great food products. And here we are at the Unity Shop. We're trying to provide nutritious food for families that are in struggling mode. They're in crisis. They're in trouble. And you're helping us not only with food products, Patricia, but you're also helping us financially.
And I want everybody out there to help Unity. And here, I'm giving this check. I want people to match me. I'm giving $5,000 today. And I want some of them to match me, all these people that have companies here in Santa Barbara. And those of you that are sitting on big bank accounts and saving accounts, give. These people need it. And Unity, they're feeding them healthy veggies and foods. And we're giving Bragg vinegar books
too. And this is year-round. We're certainly entering into the holiday season. We have thousands of families coming to us. We can't get enough food, so we need your help.
And not only that, what you do, you give them beautiful clothes. And children to have, they can have their choice of a toy. And I visited your toy land.
Yes.
And of you should come down and visit it, the Unity Shop. What they do, Tom, you are wonderful. I'm so thankful that Unity is in Santa Barbara and taking care of the needy people. And I want all of you out there to open those, get those moths out of that savings account, and give.
Hi, I'm Kenny Loggins here with Vince Cavallaro, Managing Director of Union Bank.
Thanks, Kenny. I am so excited to be here.
Yeah, tell us a little bit about Union Bank.
Well, you know, Union Bank has been serving our communities for over 150 years. And one of the things that we realize as a company, in order to be successful, you have to give back. It's so important to support our communities.
What is it about Unity that Union Bank is most drawn to?
The one thing that really stands out with me is the process. Mm-hmm. Individuals in need are able to come in and it looks as though they're purchasing goods. So if they're with their children, they're coming in, they're buying groceries, if they need clothes. And the kids, they don't know any different. They feel they're living a normal life, and it's just phenomenal for the family.
It really keeps the family together. It brings dignity back to the parents, who then know that they're supporting their families and their children in the way that the family needs.
Absolutely. And then one of the programs that really stands out is the Job Smart program. This is a true testament of what Unity is all about. It's giving them the confidence that they need, helping them write resumes, giving them clothes so they feel confident, and actually
teaching.
So they
teaching. Show up for a job interview.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly. Yeah.
Thank you, Vince, and thank you, Union Bank, for your contribution to all that you do for Unity. We can't thank you enough.
We're very glad to be here. Thank you.
I believe in Unity, and thank you, Unity, and all the volunteers.
Woo-hoo! Thank you, Patricia.
I'm Mara Aboud, and I believe in Unity.
I'm Ann Smith-Tobes, and I want to drum up support for putting Unity in
community.
I'm Vince Caballero, and Union Bank believes in unity.
I'm Kenny Loggins, and I believe in unity.
The families that find themselves at the Unity Shop have fallen on hard times. I came from one of those families. My parents came to the Unity Shop to help keep our family together during tough times. When I see the families come through, the parents shopping for the food they need, keeping a sense of dignity in front of their children. When I see kids in Santa's toy shop and they get to pick what they want, the look of wonderment in their eyes, it just melts your heart. And all of this is possible from your donations, but also from our senior volunteers who hand make clothes for infants and children. Every year, our Toy Maker Club helps make these amazing toys.
I started in 1992, and I haven't skipped a year. We've got quite a few toys out of the way in all that time, and it's such a great bunch of guys to work with.
We do 168 doll bids. We do about 75 of the dump trucks, 75 of the Rio trucks. We really enjoy doing it every year. We all pretty much get along. It probably depends on what kind of mood I'm in that day, so since I'm the teacher of the class. So.
Our local Marines collect toys you donate through their Toys for Tots program.
The Marine Corps Toys for Tots has been founded in 1947 and have been working with the Unity Shop for over 25 years. This is a great opportunity not only for our Marine recruiters, but getting the word out there that not only do they make warriors, they also work well with the community.
And yearly, the Motorcycle Toy Run raises thousands of dollars while delivering toys for our local families. I know firsthand how it feels to hit hard times and how the generosity of others helps you get back on your feet. I am thankful the Unity Shop was there for me when I needed it, but even more grateful that it's still here for others.
Now, from the Kenny Loggins Event Center at the Unity Shop in downtown Santa Barbara, the entire community comes together to support hardworking families on their path to self-sufficiency. Year-round employment and disaster services of the Unity Shop. This is the 29th Unity Telethon Celebration.
And we're back here at Matching Minutes of the Phone Bank. This is where your dollar can double by calling us for the next 2 minutes. And Tom, who's benefiting us this time?
Well, a good friend, George and Sue Frampton. George's father passed away. His name was Robert Frampton, and he was a B-24 pilot in World War II. Just a wonderful man. He passed away in November, and he basically wanted to leverage the dollars. George wants to leverage the dollars from his dad, and he wants us to keep this building for future generations. So the donation, the matching, is up to $50,000.
Wow.
And we're going to get started with it right now. So call in to help us keep this building.